You ever drive over a bump? You wonder why your steering wheel twitches like this? It's an easy way to fix it, and we're gonna show you how. All right, this phenomenon is called bump steer. Jamie, can you tell us exactly what bump steer is?
Bump steer is an unwanted or unneeded change in toe over a bump. Anytime the suspension moves up and down and your toe changes, that is bump steer. It doesn't happen as much with a stock ride height car because the steering is engineered at that specific ride height.
Right.
As you lower the car, the steering angle changes, and that angle in the outer tie rod end to inner tie rod end versus where your ball joint pivots are is what changes your bump steer. It can either aggravate it or it can fix it, depending on how everything is moved.
So obviously it's very common for Mustang owners, I'm one of them, to lower their vehicles. We love lowered ride heights. Well, with that comes changes in geometry, and bump steer is honestly a side effect of when you lower your Mustang.
It's one of the biggest problems with lowered Mustangs. Changes in roll center and changes in the steering angles are all part of lowering your car. To fix the bump steer, you have to change the angle that your steering arm is working. And the easiest way to do it is to be able to actually relocate the outer pivot of your tie rod end. This is a stock tie rod end and a bump steer tie rod end. This is a fixed length. Your ball and socket, you can't change this angle. On the bump steer kit, you can space it up and down relative to where it was stock, and be able to adjust the bump steer out. As you lower the car, your tie rods go up, and you need to be able to lower it back down to get it even with your lower control arm ball joint to help mitigate your bump steer condition.
And the key with this bump steer kit and the height adjustment that's available is you want to make this tie rod the same angle as your other control arms, correct?
The way you want to adjust the bump steer is you want to correct the steering shaft angle to the same as your control arm angle from where the two pivots are, from your inner tie rod end pivot to your outer tie rod end pivot, needs to match the lower control arm pivots. Lowering the pivot point on the outer tie rod end is the easiest way to accomplish this because your steering racks are generally solid mounted and you don't have any adjustment up or down to be able to adjust it. So the simple way to adjust it is to adjust it with your outer tie rod.
So Jamie, the way I've come to understand it is if you have the tie rod and your control arm and they're not on the same plane, when the suspension compresses, they're going to act in different ranges of motion, meaning that it's going to kick the toe out or kick the toe in, and that's when your steering wheel wants to, you know, move on its own. Is that a good way to think about it?
That's the correct way to think about it. Steering geometry and the lower control arm geometry of where the four pivots are should be parallel to one another. Mm-hmm. The closer to parallel they are, then the less bump steer effect you're gonna have as the car moves up and down, because they're moving at the same rate, they're moving in the same direction.
And we've talked about this on the street, but how is this going to benefit you on track? I feel like that's going to help you quite a bit more on track.
Because of the way you use a car on the track where you have curbing and you get the best lap time for getting as close to the curbing or on top of the curbing as you can, hitting that curbing with bump steer issues can cause lots of issues. One of them is driver comfort. You're going to feel the car do something that's not normal, and you're gonna start fighting it, and the next time you go through that same element, you're gonna slow down more. You're gonna be a little bit more careful, and that's going to affect your lap times. If you hit irregularities on the track and you start experiencing bump steer, again, it's gonna cause you to slow down, to get comfortable with what the car is doing, and that's gonna cause your lap times to suffer.
So if you do intend to lower your car, a bump steer kit is a great supporting mod. A lot of times you don't necessarily think about that. You think about camber plates or camber bolts to get your alignment in spec. But when it comes to steering geometry, that is just as important, especially the lower your car gets, the more this becomes an issue. What sets our bumpsteer kit apart from the rest is that we were one of the first companies to offer a true tapered stud for the spindle mount. While others require you to drill out your spindle and use a grade 8 bolt, that simply wasn't acceptable for us. We start with 4140 chromoly steel, machine it to exact tolerances, and then send it to heat treating for the ultimate in strength. Our bumpsteer kits include the most adjustment out of any other kit on the market, including high articulation ones around the rod end, allowing for movement without bind. The anodized billet aluminum adjuster is double adjustable, which means you can make precision adjustments without unbolting it. And finally, our rod ends are Teflon lined for a smooth and quiet operation. Now, Jamie, you do have to take this to an alignment shop pretty much immediately after installation, right?
Once you've installed this, your steering alignment's gonna be off. Toe's gonna be off for sure. You're gonna need to get it realigned. Once the toe is set properly, just verify that your bump steer setting is correct. And after that, you should be in good shape. Your bump steer should be eliminated.
Comment below and let us know if you have any questions. Bump steer is a bit complicated of a topic, but it's great once you have it figured out, whether you're on the street or on track. Hit that like and subscribe button, the notification bell, and don't forget the most important thing.
Speed matters.